The frost's creeping by the edge, weighing down the time-bent sedge. The light of the dwindling afternoon takes a stroll and crosses the pool, catching on the ragged, cold shapes that come from under black peat and take the moment cradled by the light, turning to blackness and putting to flight the little birds that tell through broken songs with half-hoarse voices. Bleak and endless, they tell of choices made before their throats tied up and before the day could end abrupt. Abrupt as the clash of metal on earth, a deadened sound, but it reverberates like the voice that sings to the clouds and won't ever die, a noisy shroud caught in the eye of he who sits by the walls, and he's just listening as the curlew calls. The hillside's covered in forgotten hope, a quiet mist that so gently chokes the minds of men like a pair of hands, cut off at the wrist but strong as the land that crumbles under the rails. Like dawn breaking, turning pale. It is as though the hillside is alive, but with torn cloths and compromise, and smoke billowing from cold fires, lit in the hearths of the little shacks that stood before, with their backs turned toward another dale, another hill, another day, and now the afternoon is fading. The light, once again, is paling. And men are making their way back down from the track. The curlew shouts at their backs. Into view the little dell comes, with half-grown trees and the creek that fells the hearts of the hardest men. As it tinkles round the stony bend, the kettle's boiled, water's thrashing against the sides and slowly learning there's no way out but through the spout or a steam. And then no doubt the air will fail you as you start. Turn to water and freeze your heart. His eyes sit like blue sky in the creek, gently edged with grasses neat and caught between lids of stone roughly hewn with frost glow. As the sun sets and throws its breath, a final light before its mouth left. His eyes are fixed on the wind in the corner, creeping through the gap in the walls. The cold is shivering by his feet, begging for the warmth he keeps. The day had started with digging, back bending, and shoulders giving way to the stubborn heels of earth that splattered his face and weren't worth the roof that teeters on the top of the walls, the boiling kettle and the steam that falls. Now he's tired. He's nights for the taking. As he sleeps, there's someone waking and shaking her head clear of the bog, and the moon is breaking through the fog. And through the crack that's in the corner, he hears a voice that seems to call, but surely it's just the wind on the bluff. Resenting the track, enough is enough. But he puts on his cap and his eyes blink open. He steps out his door to look for who's spoken. His fingers are red with the roar of the cold as he reaches the moor and searches the folds in the land for a woman calling. He hears her voice, his heart is falling. Thank you. His boots are split with all the walking his feet have done, and his legs are crawling up towards his hips, begging of his fingertips to stop the work and stop the walking. Give in to sleep, and he starts yawning and falls asleep, but she's still calling, and she walks half-bent, all stiff with frost. Her black dress, the earth it cost. Her fingers are made of half-curled roots, and she wears grey moss for her boots. Her legs are cracked and split like peat that lay under the sun for a day or a week, but they rise in beauty, like the dark, a broken shadow the moon has cast. Her hips are swaying like the wind in the trees by the bottom of the creek. The night, just by her cheek, rescinds moonlight and lights her half-drawn grin. And she's as old as him, but also the moon, like the silver in the new silver spoon, and her collarbones are fraying, made of lichen, slightly swaying in the night, and the black dress clutches for a hold, clings to her and shivers with cold, and her unsteady feet beat a sorrowful song, fingers curled but reaching onwards towards the sleeping man. His hat dislodged, and off it ran down the hill and off for the creek. Lips all sealed and never to speak of the creeping feet of the moor abroad. Her calling voice, her gently thawed face around her mouth shining where the breath comes out. All the heather that makes her hair is frozen and tangled with the moon's stare. Oh, beware of listening in the shining night. When the moor walks, the birds take flight and leave their sleepy nests. Wings cannot take their rest. Her eyes are like a fisherman's net, casting silver by the edge of the sea, steepening hills and little bluffs, and tracks that will carry all the greed of men out of the valley and up past the bend. She sees him lying. Cold eyes crying out for the kettle boiling, but it's too late, he's in thrall, and she reaches out with half-formed arms and takes him gently and means no harm. And she takes the body, slowly dying, back to where she had been lying. And now, it's she who's gently crying, her voice, a song that's always flying.